What's up, guys? Matt here, coming at you with a brand new SCX24 based build that I'm getting ready to start on. I thought I would kind of show you guys some of the stuff I'm going to put into this one. This is the chassis from NW Chassis Works. I picked this up just because it's very similar to some of the 10 scale stuff I've been building, the poised, a little bit with the very angled skid and kind of very forward mounted transmission. So I'm interested to see how that's gonna turn out and work on this. Honestly, I haven't been doing a lot with 24 builds. Like, I just kind of got burnt out on building chassis all the time. You know, like most of them at this point, we've seen it. It's just a copy of a copy of a copy. So, you know, there's not a lot of brand new stuff out there. This was somewhat new. You know, there's a lot of chassis out there that are just very similar to another. But I did have a lot of stuff here that I haven't reviewed. I've bought as it came out, just like this LGRP transmission. Very excited to get this installed in something. I bought this when they first released. Haven't used it yet. My main concern with that is I bought some optional gearing for it because I wanted to overdrive the crap out of that thing. And that's one thing some people get confused on. This was listed as an overdrive transmission. It's not overdrive to the front. It just overdrives the entire truck, basically. So don't be confused by that. I had a buddy that, a couple people that got confused. They thought this sent overdrive to the front, but it doesn't. It's actually just overdrive, period, compared to a stock SCX24 transmission. So I picked up the optional gearing. I wanted to just overdrive the crap out of that thing so that I wasn't so underwhelmed with SCX24 worm gear axles, right? So we're gonna try that. The only issue is I bought two different sets of gears and I have no idea what's what because they don't label them. So I guess I'm just supposed to sit down and count teeth for an hour. But anyways, excited to get that in. I really like that LGRP is offering a transmission, you know, that we can do that with, and you know, all these optional gearings setups. And then I have their motor as well. I picked it up a long time ago when it was released. Haven't used it. X15, another set of these axles. I love these axles. If you see my video on these, you probably know why. They're really good axles. And then I have this new setup from Fury Tech. This is the Python Pro that has the receiver built into it. So this right here is our ESC and receiver. So very nice that this is all in one. Hopefully that will work out well with this motor, transmission, everything. Links, probably gonna make some links. I'm just thinking like something similar to these that I made here. Gonna go very high clearance in the rear probably. Shorter front, I guess that's kind of the thing right now. So I just thought I would kind of show you guys some of the stuff I'm gonna be putting into this. Like I said, this is a pretty interesting chassis layout. It does come with the skid, some sliders and mag mounts, whatever. Doesn't look like it has the magnets included. So we have mag mounts, but no magnets. So I was gonna get started on this build. I wanted to show it to you guys real quick. And then I'm just gonna kind of build this thing and then we'll talk about it. All right, so it's complete and I've ran this a decent amount. I've tried several different things, played around with it, tweaked some things, and I feel like it's running pretty much where I want it right now. I may tweak a few things here or there as I go, but this thing is unbelievable right now. So this chassis mixed with these axles is almost like cheating. It's like the best thing I've drove, I think. This transmission being way forward like this, it's so easy to get it over things. So even if you hang a little bit here, because you can sometimes going up steep, very steep stuff, if you're not able to launch up over it and then slide down, you know, if it's really, really steep and you can't just launch, you got to climb your way. You can use these axles to turn and dig and get you up over that. And then you can work your way over it. Insane the lines this can pull. So those two things work very, very well together. These axles, unreal. The best axles for the SCX24. I mean, I love my X15s. They're very, very good. They're very durable. But the steering angle on these is just untouched. Crazy, crazy. and it turns it all the way through that. I mean, I've been letting these things eat, digging into the chassis, the links, everything, and they haven't broke yet. So they seem to be pretty durable. Only couple issues is just the wobble you get here. Very, very wobbly. Some people are saying you can change the hex and it will help that. I tried pretty much every hex I had and it didn't really do any good. My bearings are pretty loose in there. I've heard Meus is addressing that. And then you can just see like that double U-joint style in the front is just, you get a lot of play in it. So we'll have to see how that wears. Hopefully they hold up well. The other issue for me is the worm gear here in this front axle is just an odd width. So you can't use any of the others that we have for this. You're kind of stuck using theirs. It does come with a standard in the rear, and then they have an overdrive gear they give you, or underdrive, I'm sorry, for the rear. And I do have that in here right now. I would like to have a little bit more overdrive. So I'm thinking I may go with the Mofo underdrive in this rear to get that. I've got the LGRP transmission in here running one of their overdrive gear sets. I don't know which one because I bought both and they weren't labeled. It's running well. It's geared really high. You'll notice sometimes it's got a little tremor to it, but it's pulling it well. This LGRP Creeper motor seems to be doing its job. It runs really, really hot, but I've ran 2 to 3 packs like back to back to back pretty hard and it's been fine. So hopefully it's going to be okay. But you can see we've got a very good slow crawl. I mean, I can make this thing move to the point. You don't even know it's moving. And then we've got pretty good wheel speed with it. So far, that's working well. The Lizard all-in-one connected to this FuryTech transmitter. Working very well. This will work with pretty much any of these transmitters of this style or anything on the same protocol. Black Label 2.0 servo, you can see this is a very underrated servo. I'm just pushing it at like 6 volts right now, and it's very good, very strong. And that's one of the keys to using your steering for climbing. You'll see in some of my running, we'll talk about it, but this thing always turns these wheels. So very good servo at a good price with the aluminum horn. And one of the best things about it is the way these are rounded, the ears here, so you don't have to worry about it catching on the chassis. So it works really well on this because it's a very tight front end. Shocks, I got the Hard Park shocks up front. I just did those because they were together and I wanted a short set of shocks for the front. And then the Pro Lines, the 50 millimeter, I think they are, the longer oil shocks on the rear. I took them out of the pack, threw them on, they're working. Somebody had asked about banding the front shocks. I just use these rubber bands here that come in this pack from the dollar store, and it works very well. The reason I do that is so when you're climbing, it keeps everything from pulling away from your axle, because when everything pulls from that axle, that's what causes you to dump. So if you keep all that kind of tight, you can get a little more straight up and work your way up things. See how that kind of gives away? So the bands just kind of help that. They don't always hold it 100%. Because you still want it to flex, but you basically just, I'll probably have a hard time getting this in here on camera, but basically just wrap it around the bottom of the shock and then up around the top. Anywhere like that, and it just helps. It doesn't always, like I said, it doesn't always hold it completely, but it keeps it better than what it would. You can see that. So that just works well. And the rear, I do just have it banded to the center right now. I'm still getting really good flex and travel out of this thing. Usually on a side hill, I tell people like banding each side is a little better because see how that pulls apart. So if this was banded right here, that would stay a little more tucked in on the side hill. Whereas in the center, it still allows that to pull away. The center works well because, you know, you still get all of that, but it does on side hill let it pull away from the axle a little bit. On the rear, it's not as big a deal because I don't have much weight up here at all, so it just seems to be working for me. I just wanted to toss this in here real quick. I keep talking about how far forward this transmission is, But just in case you can't really tell by just looking at this thing, these wheelbases are basically the same. Look at where the transmission is. Maybe easier to see on this side, actually. Here and here. It's a big difference there. That's what I'm talking about. That puts your skid and everything way forward, just makes your breakover much easier. This is a similar build as well. And the angle on there really helps on this one as well. I absolutely love this chassis. This is one of my favorite old chassis. Still love the way this one performs. So it doesn't surprise me, you know, this is not way more farther forward than on this one, actually, if you took the angle out. But that angle does help us with the breakover. And just so you can see here, this is the new Fury Tech Cayman Pro SZK. See how much farther forward the transmission is here. As far as the links go, I made these links. You'll probably notice in the video, I've been trying a lot of different things. I was running these for uppers on a lot of the video. I had them actually mounted up here in this slot. I kind of ran a screw through here and it made a hole. And then I had it running from the upper there to here, obviously. And that seemed to work really well. I've been playing around with the onboard style links. Because I know a lot of people really wanted to see the RC Steve links for this. I just couldn't make myself pay $80 for them. I had planned to get this chassis and those links because I know they kind of go together. But then when I checked into those links, I was like, $80, man, I can buy a freaking SCX6 links for $80. So like I had a lot of this stuff. Actually, I had all of this stuff around. This rod is just, I keep a lot of different links of this around for making links for all of these. And it's just so cheap. You know, you can get a 5-pack of these right here for like $6.50. And that's what I used for these. I think the upper and lower, possibly I cut a little bit off. You can just cut a little bit off the threads to shorten it up some. I have rod ends from different links around here everywhere. So that's just what I did because I mean, I may be $15-$20 in a set of links, usually for a truck, depending how many pieces I need. Here you can see I used some very short hard park. I think they're supposed to be upper links here. And I think they're like a 38 or 39. Yeah, somewhere in there. I don't know what they call them, 38 or 39 probably. And then I made the uppers, which are just very, very short. So this is the shortest front end I've ever ran on one of these builds. And it really works well because you've got your breakover point is right here behind the front tires. And then as far as the rears, you can see the way this chassis is kind of meant to be ran is with your links on the outside on the upper. So I just took those rods and bent them up to make them work. And we're getting a ton of clearance there. It's a nice thin rod. I mean, they're not as nice looking as the RC Steve links, but it didn't cost me a lot. So that's just why I went with that. You know, obviously those are some very nice links. I'm not trying to put those down at all. A lot of people got mad when I made steering links. I really don't care. But for me, if I can make it cheaper with stuff that I have around here, like I'm usually gonna do that. So that's what I ended up doing. And I've kind of been playing around with these. I didn't really like the way they were running with the links on the outside at first, but I had a little different shock setup. The biggest part of the running is with these links on the inside here. And that just worked really well. But I have been kind of going back and forth testing things. So that's why right now it is set up like this. That's kind of why this video took me a while to get out because I have really been doing a lot of different things to this thing and trying to play around with it. So that's just what I did for links for now. So really probably the last thing are wheels and tires. And right now I'm running ruptures with flubs in the front, stock foams in the rear, and on these brass wheels. And really, I just ended up with these wheels because these ruptures were already mounted to them. I wanted to run ruptures. I started out planning on running these, and I still plan on putting some ruptures on some of these because I love the look of these wheels. And I'll link all this stuff in the description. So if you like these, they'll be in the description. But right now, these brass wheels give this a good weight, and it's just killing lines. So loving the way this thing's performing. Definitely my favorite to drive right now, for one, just because of steering. It works so well on my indoor course. And then the chassis, the clearance, and the transmission being way forward, it all just works very well. You can see I have just a hair between the motor and servo. It just worked out. Like, it all went together very well and is working perfectly. So you guys let me know what you think about it. We'll get into some running, and I'll talk more about everything. You'll see in a few of these clips, I'm actually running the trenchers on this truck, and they seem to do pretty well. I like that I can play around with some of these smaller tires on this truck. You know, it's got so much clearance that you can kind of put the thing down real low with smaller tires and still be able to get over a lot of things. This build's really the perfect build for this time of year because I run a little more indoors right now. It's raining a lot, you know, it's cold, it's nasty. So this is the time of year that I really put the indoor course to use. And this truck runs great indoors, you know, with the turning angle on these axles. I can pretty much turn and go anywhere and make any kind of line I want. And then with the clearance of this truck, you can see there, it just kind of walks up over everything. Unbelievable on the indoor course. You know, my course is not real hard. I tried to build this course to where I could test stock trucks or I could test trucks like this. You know, it's kind of got that even mix. But there are some tougher things that you can hit. I hit a few things just kind of completely odd that I'd never really done before just to see if this truck could get over it, and it did everything. This right here is one spot. The bridge is very tight. You got to have a decent turning angle. A lot of times you have to back up right there. With the new Fury Tech that I just tested recently, I had to back up to make that turn. So these axles, you can just turn on a dime basically. Right here, this line, a lot of trucks just won't even go up this, and this actually just kind of makes it look easy. With all of the clearance on the belly, these ruptures almost like cheater tires. I mean, they just grab and go. And I just like having a more normal size tire on this build. It's nice to have a truck that can run a smaller tire and perform really well. You know, we just keep going bigger and bigger with our tires. People not really building trucks that are super capable. They just throw a 73 millimeter tire on it and say it's amazing. And I'm just kind of over the huge tire thing. You know, it's like driving a 10th scale on this course. If you're running 1.9s on this thing, yeah, of course it's going to roll over everything, you know. So I like a little bit smaller tire. Like these right here are kind of perfect. I don't mind like the 68 millimeter DJ crawlers. Those are really good tires, but they are really as big as I want to go on these trucks and only for certain builds. And, you know, when I want to run a body, which I do most of the time, I want something about the size of these ruptures. I wouldn't mind them being just a hair bigger, but I wouldn't mind seeing a set of them a little bit smaller either, you know? So this right here is a pretty tough pull for this motor. You can see there's a lot of pressure on those rear tires, and it's able to pull that up and over. I'm really kind of surprised it did that as well as it did, because this thing is geared pretty high, so I think this motor's doing a very good job paired with this gearing and everything. It all just works out pretty well. I've had a lot of people ask me about these axles versus the Mofo X15s because really those were my previous favorites. And now I'm kind of going to lean towards these. There's a couple things to consider. I think the Mofo axles are a better build quality overall. The bearings are not loose. Everything fits tighter. There's not as much play and wobble in the wheels And we have lots of gearing options. He has the standard, you know, worm gear fit, fits in there fine. And then he has tons of options and stuff. So all of those things are definitely things to consider. But the steering angle on these is just nuts. I haven't drove anything like them. Modded stock axles, modded FCX, modded CR18Ps, whatever. TRX4M, none of them really compare to what these things can do. So if they continue to hold up, these are probably the number one axle. My only concern is just having that play in the bearings and things kind of loose out of the gate. It just means you're going to get more and more wear. So we'll have to see how they hold up. But so far, I've put them in a lot of tough positions, and nothing is broke, bent, anything like that. They seem to be handling it fine. So at the moment, I really like these. I like the price of them as well. So I kind of have to recommend these. But you're not going to go wrong with the X15s at all. And I feel like they are beefier and just going to be a little tougher overall probably. This is another spot where the traction is pretty low. These rocks are actually really slick and they're just kind of tossed in here. This is a little more of a chunky, rough section. Not really any good line through there, but you can see the steering really helps me get through this. It's where it's important to have a good steering servo. No matter how I wedge that in there or put how much pressure I put on that front tire there, it's still able to turn the tires and just kind of work my way back and forth, and it helps me get up and over this. So in the end, this is a great chassis, in my opinion. I love how the transmission and skid sits so far forward. If you look at it, it's just right behind the front tires. So if you get your front tires over it, you're pretty much already to the breakover point. And it makes a lot of jagged rocks just very easy. I can't wait to get this thing out to some really good crawling spots. You know, I didn't get much time with it outdoors. It's been nasty raining here lately. So hopefully soon I'll get out to some better spots with it. Going to keep playing around with it. Maybe stiffen the roof shocks a tiny bit. But overall, love the way it's performing so far. And definitely look forward to playing around with it more. These axles are absolutely amazing. If you haven't tried these, definitely check them out. It's worth waiting on them. Sometimes you gotta wait for these things to come in a little while. Just keep an eye on Amazon. I'll link them in the description. Sometimes they pop up there and you can get them on Prime. The LGRP transmission seems to be working great. I like that we have different gearing options there. This Creeper motor is working well. The MofoRC Black Label is working well. Of course, the FuryTech ESC is working well. So you guys let me know what you think about this build, and definitely look forward to getting more time out with it. I appreciate everybody watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, click the bell. Peace.